There was a big car chase that was in the movie at one time. It was this really elaborate setup to kidnap Angela. I remember we had this meeting about how expensive it was, literally a day or two before the Matrix trailer came out for the second film. And I saw a piece of that highway chase. I mean, how are we ever going to top that chase sequence? So we knew we had to change it. And I remember meeting with Keanu. We were having a script meeting, just he and I, and we were sitting around talking. And I don't even remember how this came up, but we came up with the scene of Rachel getting sucked through the walls of Balthazar's building, through the cubicles and hallways and the conference room and out the window. And
the outbuilding sequence was an amalgam of some beautiful special effects work built on full-scale sets by Alan Hall and his guys, by a great deal of CG that was contributed by the folks at ESC, and by Rachel herself, who shot green screen in most of these shots.
What's wrong?
I don't know. I just feel...
It was really pretty simple. Rachel has to be pulled all the way through this building, one room at a time. So we built all of the rooms, with the exception of the room full of cubicles, which was built as a miniature only. We built the conference room, of course, as a full-scale set. We built the hallway as a full-scale hallway. Then working with the art department and with Alan Hall, I had them build breakaway sections of those that would automatically blast out on cue. And then we shot all those as background plates. We shot Rachel on a green screen to put into that. And then we added on top a great deal of CG debris and papers and staplers.
What are you trying to say?
Change anything, or let's just safety and do it.
Want to add some more sparks? I think they went off before you actually saw them.
I don't really bother reading the action bits because I like read the dialogue and the psychological stuff. And I obviously skipped through quite a few pages.
Number one position, please, guys. Here we go.
Are we going all the way up? I should probably throw out my chewing gum at some point.
Chewing gum. Because
is this a real thing or a
hazard? No,
it's a real thing.
Because they might be preparing for whatever their character's doing or whatever else is going on in their life at this moment. But my concern with them, not only is their performance level, but is their safety generally.
RA would be a great cult leader. You know, he could get you to do anything. I promise you, he just looks you in the eyes, and he just has this way, and he'll just say, I just want you to jump off that cliff, and it will be fine. And you go, oh, okay.
Like as wild as
right.
And stuff here.
Like you're just a ragdoll.
Well, I am just a ragdoll.
Yeah. She accuses me of hypnotizing her is what it is. And it's really not that, but I try to be very calm with her and with all of them, but also make eye contact. I'm not trying to avoid telling them the truth.
I might just sit down for a second.
Absolutely.
Can I?
All right, well done.
There was a time when I thought, I don't think I can do it. He just took me aside and he just said, you can do it. And I was like, oh, I can do it. Yeah, he's very persuasive, Ari.
Doing the splits.
Oh, okay, they should stay in the same position.
Stay, you know, not as extreme in the kicks.
Okay.
Okay?
When they come in to work with us and we've done our job and they're doing their job, the idea is it's strictly acting now. It's not about survival. It's not about being scared. It's all about acting.
It's fun.
So that's it. Well, I don't know. I think and then...
Then we'll do the have that shot the yesterday.
What we did yesterday, you get sucked through those doors.
Yeah.
And this shot is a shot of a series of office cubicles that are being blown aside as she's being pulled through the building. We couldn't really do it full scale because this would be a very large set. So miniature was a natural decision.
What we're using on this set here is a motion control system. We have the cart that goes underneath the set that has the doll that represents the actress in the movie. She's getting pulled through the set.
There were, I think, about 80 cues on the way through for all the walls to be pulled apart. They're all pulled apart on wires. All these air mortars are blowing stuff in the air. Things are all flying around. The camera drops as all the walls of the cubicles blow out. And just at the end, you see this little figure fly under camera, which is Rachel. So we had to build a little maquette, a little model of Rachel, which you see behind me.
Action!
Oh, and look, it was great how it just went over her head.
another successful shoot.
We didn't have to build that office out of CG. We didn't have to sit there and animate papers flying through the air for that shot. We really could get the shot essentially entirely in camera, see dailies the next day, know we had the shot, just do a little cleanup and go away. And this was a perfect application of that. And then the final last shot, the camera's pulling Keanu through, and you wind up with Keanu stopping at the window, and the camera continues to pull back as if it's Rachel's POV. And you see Keanu standing in the window of this office building, and you see Los Angeles laid out behind him. And this was my favorite shot in the movie.